toes. Nagi. Watch carefully. Not like this. Hoping that your arms are strong enough to get by. Okay, watch carefully. No arm. Just the body. Once you're here, now you're with him. Then, you don't need to use your arm. As soon as I lose my center, this is what we're looking at with the sword. Same. It's like cutting and going back. This way is centered. Go back to the center wherever you go. So centered, centered, centered in Jodan. And you throw, and you're centered again. Don't lose these principles. The most important you can find in Aikido is centering. Do it some more. Actually, there shouldn't be that much of a problem. This is where you want to go. You want to go here. Okay. If you try it, hold really tight. If you try doing this, he's going to control. Most people try to do this, bang, and they win because of power. This is not, look. I'm only exaggerating, but this breaks his position. So you've got to do that all in one step. Irimi, it's right here. What did we do yesterday? Speed, we did this. This way. Now with the hand. Oh, the same. You must get this in. Then once you have this, now, look, that's a bit of detail. But we think in terms of the end of the movement, so we're immediately trying to get to this point. And this is what's important. Here, here. Now this is no problem. It's not where he can resist. You set the situation up so he can't resist. Then you hit him and hit him where he can't resist. Okay, we think Aikido is really moral, but when you think about it, you put the adversary where he can't resist, and then you let him have it. So, but it's not that bad. It sounds bad, but here you break up his position, break up his balance. Once you've broken up his balance, you can work. But if you don't break up his balance and put him in a weak spot, then you're all the time fighting against him. Try it. This is good. This is good. Same. But if you're doing this, you're only thinking of throwing. Try to create this. Now, this is good. And this is good. Try it. So, one. Don't get your centering, if you don't get your movement here, now you're not building. This is building. This is building. You built this possibility. So you should have this freedom of choice. And this place is the same. You make the mistake of building a movement only thinking of one thing. Okay? So, here. Let's do this. Same. Okay, so this way, bring your body back. Keep coming in there.
the comida. There
you go. Head here and focus this way. Okay. So you should have no problem. One is cutting here, one is cutting here, one is cutting here. Go ahead. Ikkyo. Go for your immediate movement. This overall, even though you're using tenkan, you want to have this. So that this exists. So that this exists. All of it exists at the same time. Here, this exists. Make sure that you get a good position. Don't just be satisfied with this. This doesn't work. I'm off center. If I'm in center, you can't be in center. If I'm off center even a little bit, you can be in center. The whole point is getting your own center. Same as each, just a little smaller. Make it small. This way. Hey, Nikyo. The same beginning. Look, don't get involved with his wrist. Don't start fiddling around. You know, fiddling around. How do you say that? Andy, fiddling around.
Roomful made.
Okay? You get up here and you start fiddling around with the wrist, wondering about how to do something on the wrist. All you need is a cut. Up. Just cut, like you would do with a sword. Here. Here. Up. This way. Then afterwards you take care of the rest. Okay, so try to relax. You don't have to kill somebody. Because you're hurting his wrist. If your Aikido depends, and I keep saying this over and over again all the time, never measure the effectiveness of your Aikido by the degree of pain that you inflict. Because someday there'll be people that are not going to feel it the same way. Okay? If you're going to do a movement, what you're basically creating here is not a position where, because he hurts, he's hurting so bad he has to go down. Create an unbalanced position here, where now he can't resist, because he has nothing to resist with. Okay? And like I said the other day, is instead of inflicting pain, create a situation where mentally he's got much more fear of the pain than the pain itself. And usually you get it done. And that's what happens. You create a situation, for example, here, where he says, Jesus Christ, if he does that, I'm gonna get a broken wrist. That's very important. But if you allow him to be strong here and he's there and he's saying, okay, I think I can resist, okay, then it's not as you're not doing as much acting in a sense. So you want to create a situation where there's not much to do. And it doesn't have to hurt. It just has to think it might hurt. Okay, try again. Watch! Look. All you're doing is this. One. No more difficult than that. Over here, right? You've got your movement up, cut down. And that's extending differently than if you're doing, this is what I call fiddling around with this. Okay. Up, and from here. It's the directions you work in. Yeah. Same body, we just changed hand. Okay. Try it. Jujigarai. I forgot to say this, but you've got to let go of the inside hand. If I'm here, it's just out of politeness. Normally you don't. This movement has a meaning combatively of this. His head. Bang. And just finished. There's no Nage was out in it as a combative movement. But as a training movement, we've made it to Nage was out, so you actually throw somebody. Okay? But when you throw somebody, be careful here, let go of the hand that he needs to protect himself. So yeah, I'm helping you. You just have to find which hand it is. Okay? Normally it's this one. Okay? So when I come back here, look. And I've helped it. That way you can train for many years of your life and enjoy a ripe old age without having back problems. If you hold both, look. You can't fall. Or if he falls, he has to find another way to fall. Or you break his arm.
Come on, break his arm.
Come here. Just try to get it. Try. So find, it's the one that grabs a hold is the one that will hold out. Oh, look, this is another thing. On Jujigarami. If you just are happy doing this, like this, many times you'll just fall and bam and hurt yourself. So you want to help him. Here, then, this is helping. It also is worthwhile to keep in mind if you want to go further. Okay. So, do it some more. You've got several choices. You can do this, look. Okay, I've gone backwards. Here, you can stay where you are. This way. And you can go back tenkan again. I've gone, this is what I've been doing, is this way. I went back again. And I did that intentionally, so that you can do this here, back, and here. Koshi. Okay. Huh? Here. This way. Try it. You're using the arms as a leverage point, and once again, it's not because it hurts that it should work. This way. Now, here. And, look, up and underneath. That way. Okay? That's very different from doing something like this. Like that. You're guiding with this hand. Let go of this hand for a moment. This hand. Okay. This hand is going like this. Okay, so think of this hand. use that as your guiding hand.
One.
Is to feel that you've got this freedom. Once you're here, this is fairly free. If I'm here, this is not free anymore. So it's this centered. This gives you freedom. Okay? So get well centered. You're up in Jodan. Okay? So now, we can do Kotegaishi and a whole pile of other things. Right now, Kotegaishi. So, try it. Hey. Don't do this. If you bend, look. If I've got a right angle here, the flowingness of my energy is usually stopped. There's nothing that says you have to have a right angle here. Okay? This, look, this is free. Hold tight. Don't let me move. Okay? I can still move. So you can adjust with your body, or I can adjust with this. I don't know. Whichever you wish. You're free in both cases. Be centered. And look. Here. This position is like this, so that you've got the same position as you use here. Nobody goes here. Okay? It looks funny, right? But it doesn't make sense to do this. This is not, you're not working with the extension. So the basic movement that you practice tries to get your body to use angles that are strong here. This. Okay. Here. With the right angle here. Okay. That is not strong. Put this out. 45 degrees. Then, come on. Not stiff. Okay. Right. You do. I'm here. Right? Bam! That's what I mean. This is what you create. You create when you do ikkyo. You want this. Then you're using that weakness in order to do a movement. So don't make yourself weak. As you learn in the movement is a weakness when you do ikkyo. Keep this. If you want to do ikkyo, and he can keep his arm out here, you're going to have problems doing ikkyo. It's not easy. When you want to do ikkyo, you want to get this. Now you're ikkyo. So you can follow the elbow. So ikkyo will teach you, again, it's the same. So here, this out this way. So when you get to the end of your movement, here, drop. Same. And where were you? You were. Okay. So, here, there's the extension you want. So, from there, rather than being here, there, now. This can work with your body, as opposed to, I've been watching many of you, you're turning like this. Do it with this. Whoa. And the bottom. So to make it clearer, do it this way. This. Irimi-nagi. Now with your try it. It's always the same. Oh no. If you do this, see how he gets his balance back? Watch. And your body. Okay. And try to find the direction where he can't get his balance back. Limited if you think only of one thing. But if you begin to do your whole yimi movement right here, now it's begun. This is why so often we do this like that. It's not practical. It would never be a combat move. You're not going to make anybody fall on that. Either let's go or whatever. It's for practice, for understanding the principle. So there's no use worrying about whether you're effective or not. You're effective only when you fulfill the principle in Aikido. You're not effective just because you make somebody fall or you hurt him. Does that make sense to you? Huh? We so often we measure a movement saying, well, he fell, or we're happy enough because he was on the ground. You don't need Aikido to put somebody on their butt. Right? There's a lot of techniques that do that, and they're not necessarily Aikido. This is the principle right there. With the same principle, you realize now you can move around. So, here. So, move around. Sanghyo. One more. Yes. Here. This way. If you're like this, this is going to be difficult. Hold tight. Okay? Like this. If you've got the extension, look. So, try it. Okay, watch. A lot of you are moving the hand when you should be moving the body. Here, don't do this. First of all, this is hard to break, okay? And second of all, when you go here, when you go underneath, he's in balance. You've made a position where he's off balance. We've already gone through this all night. Look at his position. Don't ruin this. This is nice. So leave it where it is and go you through. And then you realize that there's no difference between this and this for him. His balance is you're using it the same way. All right, tomorrow. Okay. Now keep going backwards. Doesn't matter if you turn, you're going to stop it from turning if you like. Okay. If you keep the contact here, keep this contact as you turn, then you've got this. Again, this is more of a type of exercise than training movement. Try it. Okay, now again. For your ukemi, okay, as I said, this movement, again, always distinguish what is meant to be a training of principle and one that will be more effective. Effective would be Sankyo, for example, but here, as, go ahead, keep going, go through, up. I didn't do anything in particular. A lot of you, when you're doing ukemi, you get stiff and everything, and so you're here, and then you start going. And turn in, and then you change the Sankyo. It doesn't matter. Just keep in mind that this movement right here, you don't have to worry about it. You can change it, but it's not important. When we get involved in one movement without thinking of what actually exists elsewhere, this is also important. It's not that important. What's important is to get this up here, get the feeling of using your body. And for that, your ukemi is present to help you. You get it correct. You get it correct, he holds. He holds, but he doesn't change. If I do this, watch, do it again. If I do this, okay, I'm changing the situation. I don't. I just hold. It's going to work well. Come on.
Yes.
Let's say, right. Now up. Now keep going. So I gave him a hard time, I gave him something to work with. But I wasn't trying to beat him, I wasn't trying to say, you know, you're no good or the movement's no good. I don't have an opinion, I just want him to be good. So you hold tight in relation to what you can do. Come on. What do you think? Think I can stop her movement? Huh? Of course I can. But then I can't work. We can't work. She can't work. But if I am okay correctly, it doesn't matter who or what experience I have with you in front of me. Here.
Going.
Come on. And we work. It's not a problem. I know I can work. Immediately people would say, ah, oh, it's unfair. But when you get closer to being together at the same level, you begin to think, oh, I got home. But always remember, ukeru means to receive. So your movement is receiving this movement. You're the reflection of what he's doing. Does that make sense? Okay, do geiko. Do anything you wish from there. Try to get this movement and then do every movement. A lot of you are falling back into old habits. And instead of having this movement as being strong, you're going into this right away. And when you if you begin by animating this part of your body, you immediately tell him what you're trying to do. Okay? This contact point he gets information from. Particularly if he's ukeru, he's receiving all the information. So if you give him the information, it's going to make it harder for him. Okay? If you do this, for example, there's no information here. Right? Okay? So you've got a lot of possibilities other than here. And what we do is very first thing, try to move here. The real estate that he's squatting, you want to take it back. Forget that. Try to use your body. And this is not taking back here. This is free. And until you get to a good spot, you can put more energy later. Now you've gotten your footing. But if you immediately start by wanting this, then you tell him what you're doing and he knows how to resist. And then you want the center. So, the same is true with the sword. if I do this, if I start by turning like this, I can't move here. Okay? Tenkan is not just pivoting around like this. This way. This is the feet. That way. And so that if you put it together, it would be this way. But you don't just pivot around with the back. This. You want to get this feet. So that you have. It's a little difficult to do in the beginning. So try two by two. One, two. Same time as he cuts, you cut up. This is going to be this way. You don't have to touch him, but the idea is this. This way. Okay. If it's the other side you're working on, you can do it too. Okay. That's not the same. This is your back foot. Your back foot doing this. Your back foot push. Pivot. Now it just steps back. And the movement can be very simple. Try it, two by two. Watch out for your neighbor. Okay, that's the basic movement that you build tenkan on. In other words, this way. It doesn't matter. But you want to keep your balance in front of your body this way. And not allow the back of your body. I keep repeating this. I think it's worth it. Every time I look at anybody work, I see inevitably somebody doing this, where now your center of gravity is in your rear end. You want it here. So one, two, three, it's always in front of you. So, stand up, everybody. So here, now you're going to do this way. One. Like this. Okay? This movement has the same meaning. No? Okay. Sounded like this way. This way. Don't raise your sword like this. Okay. It just has to go here, over the top of your head, in the center. So, one. Now, boom, cut forward. Good. Okay. So, one. One. Okay, this movement is going to make you have a tendency to do this, but don't give in to it. This way, this way, this way, oh, straight lines. And those straight lines, when they're put all together, they'll look like a nice curving movement. Come on. Hey! Don't move. You can stay here. Okay, so, hey, one, pivot. As though nobody does this, it doesn't make sense to the sword. This does make sense though. Okay. Because you can find these. Each one of these. It doesn't matter, the body movements are all there. It's the same. So I leave it up to you to discover them. Discover for yourself. So that's it. Thank you very much.
Master?